Hello and welcome back. It is Gauntlet of Greatness playoff time. I'm Randy Bueller. I'm joined by Shadow Nutella. We have one quarterfinal match left, and it's a good one. We're up here in the top right corner of the match with 90s era brokenness at its finest. The Tinker deck that John Finkel used to win the world championship in a mirror match against Bob Maher Jr. versus the Yawgmoth Bargain deck, Zvi Bargain, the last combo deck standing after all the Urza Saga shenanigans had gotten banned out. So that is going to be the matchup. Here is a good look at... It's a bunch of fast mana. Key, Monolith, Metalworker. It's some disruption in the form of Tanglewire, Helix, and Crumbling Sanctuary. And then the creature set, you've got this Phyrexian Colossus, 8/8, super hard to block, pay life to untap, pay 16 to deal 24, works out. You've also got Phyrexian Processors that can just spit gigantic token creatures into play. We saw 19/19 in the Finals of Worlds that year, pretty cool. And then Master Core is good against the creature decks, probably not great in this matchup, but I mean, whatever, you just need something to attack with sometimes. The Bargain deck basically makes the assertion that if I can put Yawgmoth Bargain into play, I can kill you on the spot. The kill, maybe not the most elegant kill in the history of the world, right? It's Mox Diamond, Grim Monolith, Voltaic Key as your artifacts, and then Turnabout, targeting yourself, untapping all of your own artifacts, gets you a ton of colorless mana, and enough colored mana for, you know, the other turnabouts, and then eventually you just blaze them. You just point an X spell at their face and deal 20. That's how good Yawgmoth Bargain is, right? Get it into play, and then on the spot, you can just draw, you know, 19 cards. Maybe Delusions of Mediocrity comes down, lets you draw 29 cards. That's enough, usually, to just blaze them out. Dark Ritual throws some sauce in as well. Show and Tell can cheat the Bargain down early. That's the matchup. I am going to play the Bargain side of things. Shadow is going to be on the Tinker side. All
right, on the side with a prayer. It has a chance.
Yeah, I feel like my era of Standard, I sort of a year earlier, I get Tempest, whereas you get Mercadian Masks. So I think my era of Standard's a little more powerful. But Tinker's pretty ridiculous as cards go. And all of that, we both have all the fast artifact mana. It's sort of a question of like, what's the better way to abuse it, right?
Yeah, absolutely. I think yours is better. Mine can work. Mine requires a really good hand. Yours requires you to draw 7 cards, so we'll see how it goes.
All right, match is up. Come fight me. I will mute you on Skype. We will chat more after the match. Good luck to you.
Good luck to you.
All right, let's do this. Ah, lost the diamond. Boo. What is this? This is 2 Vampiric Tutors? Weird. So a Vampiric for... It doesn't even work. I mean, I can Vampiric for Show and Tell, Vampiric for Bargain. And then I'll have 2 Mox Diamonds. I might actually keep this. Like, the Vampirics, if I draw anything, like... Basically, every card in my deck helps me. Even a 3rd land would allow me to set up a turn 3 kill. I think if I keep... Yeah, I basically need my turn 2 draw step and my turn 3 draw step for the Vamps. Turn 1 draw step has to be something, though. It either has to be a Bargain or a Show and Tell or some mana. As long as it's one of those things, then I can use Vampiric Tutors to go get a Bargain and a Show and Tell. I mean, there's a couple of blanks. I do not need this stuff right now. Scroll Rack. Great. One of the blanks. Sort of. I mean, I can use the Scroll Rack, so I probably just play it here, right? I get Root Water Depths, Mox Diamond, have the Scroll Rack in play on turn 1. Sure. Thank you. No. Am I activating the scroll rock on my upkeep? I kind of want to see if he plays a port or not. Oh, you guys can't see the gameplay. My apologies. Here is the gameplay. So, yeah, all you missed is he played an island on the first turn, and I had these cards. My turn one draw step was the scroll rack, so I kept Mox, Mox, Land, Land, Vamp, Vamp, Delusions, and then drew scroll rack. If he plays a port, then I can kind of save this land for scroll rack. I don't know if I want to vamp on my first draw step. I mean, my next draw step. I might just draw a card. The fact that I have scroll rack and like being able to vamp after I scroll rack is kind of nice. Because it reshuffles. But it's also nice to get the card I want, but it's also nice to have more cards. I think I go on the scroll rack play because he's not putting any pressure on me whatsoever. I draw a swamp. Okay, so that turns on Mox Diamond. What's the play here? Is it scroll rack? I think it's scroll rack. Keep one vampiric tutor. So that I can reshuffle these cards away. If I decide I want to. Alright. Oh, those are good cards. Draw the bargain. Draw a dark ritual. I have a swamp. So I can ritual for show and tell if I want to. I mean, a vampire tutor for show and tell if I want to. And the next turn I'd be able to show it down. But I can also just kind of ritual it out. No, 3, 4, 5. Cannot ritual it out. So I'm probably vampire tutoring for show and tell. Which of these cards do I want to draw if I do get another turn? It's either the Mox or the Swamp. I think it's the Swamp. No, it's gotta be the Mox. Alright. Tanglewire would be annoying here. Now, I mean, this two untapped islands would be scary out of a different deck, but his main deck doesn't have any permission whatsoever, so I don't have to worry about that. I think I just Vampiric here. I don't want to give him all day because he could set up Tanglewire turns. Yeah, I'm just going to Vampiric for a show and tell. Draw that and go off to the races. Ooh, may as well Dark Ritual. Guess what my last card is? I brought 17 cards for show. Oh, he's got Crumbling Sanctuary. Hilarious. So, Crumbling Sanctuary means instead of targeting his life total, I'm now targeting his library. So, my whole plan of blaze for 20 it now requires me to blaze for 50 instead, which is harder but doable. Hilarious. Yeah, a bunch of turnabouts. Okay, good monolith. They're pretty good draws. I mean, kind of the question at this point is, am I saying go and giving myself an untap step? Or am I just going for it? Well, I know that I'm going to play a land and a monolith, so I can draw a couple more cards. Please. Another monolith. It'd be nice to get all these monoliths down. Which I can, right? I just go land, monolith, tap it for monolith, key for monolith. Even gives me scroll rack mana. Oh, and I have a vampiric tutor. So Monolith. Yeah, I have key, and I have either Vampiric or Activate Scroll Rack. But not both. So, what am I doing? These cards are pretty good. I feel like it's time to just say go. Sure. Passing a turn is a little scary. It's not a catastrophe against him. Yeah, now he's got a 4/4. So he's going to make me win next turn. Which I don't blame him for. Now, I could Vampiric Tutor for what? Delusions? Let's draw 10 cards. Seems pretty good. Sure. Delusions of Mediocrity. 4 mana, gain 10 life. Yeah, don't want to get hit by Master Core, so pretty much time to go for it here. But I guess I could buy an untapped step at the cost of 4 life. Which is 4 cards, maybe. Doesn't seem like I will need to. What do I have going on? So I've got the 2 turnabouts, and I've got the Yawgmoth's Will. What I really need are just more Monoliths and more Mox Diamonds. I need Mox Diamond in particular. I mean, I could Vamp Tutor for it. I could also Scroll Rack once I get a handful of stuff. And then Vamp Tutor to reshuffle. Feels pretty good, actually. Go to like 7. Now I am going to Scroll Rack and throw away all the cards I don't want. What did we find? We found a Mox, a Monolith, and a Key, and the other Turnabout. It feels like it should be good enough. So, colorless for the key. I can Dark Ritual. I can Dark Ritual again. I've got a ton of black mana. I can. I think what just happened? What just happened? Did I just misclick the Yawgmoth's Will? I just misclicked Yawgmoth's Will when I was aiming for Dark Ritual. Shadow, I just misclicked a Yawgmoth's Will when I was trying to cast Dark Ritual. But I have everything here. I have 3 turnabouts, a Mox Diamond, a Grim Monolith. Like, I can blaze you for 50 here, I promise.
Good enough for me.
Yeah, I've got it all. Thank you. Alright, on to game 2. Sorry about that, guys. But yeah, turnabout, turnabout, turnabout. They all make mana. Then I Yawgmoth's Will. Turnabout, turnabout, turnabout. I have more than enough mana at that point to just blaze in for the full 50. So, let's go to sideboarding. The bargain deck is up again. And I don't think I care enough about his permission to bring in Defense Grid. I mean, Disenchant's good against him, but, like, I don't know that I want to bring reactive cards into my deck. Like, what am I taking out? I don't want to take out mana. I can't take out Blaze. I don't want to take out Tutors. I don't want to take out Bargains. I don't want the one will. I want, like, three turnabouts and three delusions are set up so that I can intuition for them. I think I just run it back. Like, until he shows me that he can beat me, I think I just run it back. Good. See what happens. Okay, what does this draw do? This draw almost casts a bargain, but doesn't. But it has a scroll rack. It's like key, rack. I think it's good enough, right? I just need a way to get a bargain into play, and like everything counts. I guess Monolith doesn't count because I only have one black mana, but I have the scroll rack, so I'm going to keep it. And I don't really want to go all in on a turn two kill against him when he has a couple of counters in the sideboard, and he has a nulls, and he has miscalculations. I don't think I want that yet. I think I just want to stick to this scroll rack plan. Right, see what I've racked into and come up with the Imperial Tutor as a reshuffle effect. If you guys weren't here earlier, I'm going to hype for the deck building contest once again. Happy to have this in the video. Our next season of Gauntlet of Greatness is going to be no banned list modern. Going to be awesome. And we actually are having a deck building contest. So send me your decks, contest@cardkingdom.com. And I will pick out the best ones. I will put them into the next season of the Gauntlet of Greatness. And if your deck wins, you get a box of Modern Masters. Your deck just makes the top 8. You actually get some store credit with Card Kingdom. So that should be fun. And yeah, there you go. What was it? Contest? Yeah, contest@cardkingdom.com. Anytime in the next 3 weeks, and you could win. Or you could at least make our next season entertaining, which, well, then we all win. I feel like putting some black mana here. I mean, I could sack crystal. I don't feel like sacking crystal maid yet. I don't feel like I'm under a ton of pressure. I mean, obviously Grim Monolith, he can start to cast some threatening things. He can tinker out of Colossus. He can play Tanglewire. That's kind of my worst case scenario here. And it's not good. It's also not the end of the world. And the fact that I have so little colored mana in this draw is not exactly ideal. But we'll see where we get to next turn. Well, 6 cards in my hand when I activate the scroll rack, so I'm gonna play this. But he's got nothing? Okay. Very good. What else? Phyrexian Processor, sure. How much life is he going to play? So, Phyrexian Processor, he's paid 10 life. This gives him the ability to pay 4 mana and tap this to put 10 tens into play. He can't do that before my next turn, so I feel like I've got 2 turns. I obviously do not want to get hit by a 10-10 creature. But I could scroll rack and then Vampiric Tutor. Yeah, the question is how many of these cards I put on the scroll rack? Actually, clearly hold the Vampiric Tutor, right? I don't know if I want to hold the bargain. Let's see what we can find. think the Vampire Tutor is the only one that's irreplaceable at this point. They have a lot of land they don't really want to redraw. So I'm going to rack for 5. And I found nothing but a bunch of tutors. That's actually kind of awful. Blah! How does that work? That is crap. I want to hit my land drop for the turn. I have no bargain. I mean, I could draw the bargain. Not cast a Vampire Tutor. I can't afford an intuition. I could actually use Voltaic Key to untap Scroll Rack. I can also, if I draw the bargain and then go Vampiric, activate Scroll Rack to get the card. Wow, this is terrible. I guess I should have held the bargain? I'm not supposed to hold the bargain here. Alright, I'm going to say go. He's going to put a 10-10 into play. I get a turn. Then he attacks me with a 10-10, which I obviously don't want to have happen. So how do I get bargain down next turn? It's basically my question. How do I get bargain down next turn from here? I think I have to key the scroll rack, draw the bargain, and then upkeep Vampiric. A weird spot. Yeah, I'm gonna key the scroll rack, activate the scroll rack to draw the bargain, and then vamp on my next upkeep. Probably worth drawing the turnabout, right? Instead of something. Might even be worth drawing land. Yeah, these other two Vampirics are not good, and the intuition is not good. So I can rack for 3 here. Get back. Bargain the turnabout in the city. Now during my upkeep, I can Vampiric for show and tell. To let me get the bargain down. Yep. He gets a Colossus. So he's Colossus, and he has the ability to attack me for 18 next turn. Time to go for it. None of this wondering about an untapped step. Just gotta win. I guess I have to consider the possibility of a null and miscalculation as well. It would be nice to play Delusions. So I have a land draw. I could do City of Traders into Monolith. Makes a bunch of colored mana. Key makes even more colorless mana. Vampiric? I don't know if I need Vampiric at this point. Another Mox Diamond, that's good. Could stop at 4. Maybe I'll stop at 5. How many lands do I have? I have the city, the Root Water Depths, and the City of Traders. Doesn't feel like I need colored mana for my lands, because I have Ritual for all the black. 2 Mox Diamonds. Yeah, I'm going to get started with colorless mana. find out if he has an annul. Probably annul this. It's also possible I should have played a Mox Diamond so that I could ritual and pay for a miscalc. That's probably what I should have done. I should have a Mox Diamond in play so that I could Dark Ritual to pay for a miscalculation. I don't even know if he brought them in. Well, they don't seem great against me in general. Wonder if he's even there. He's just wandered off. He does have the annul. Okay. Huh. Now, having Grim Monolith makes this draw kind of awkward, not gonna lie. Wonder if it's worth Demonic Tutor for Monolith. Might be. So if I Vampiric Tutor, I can then play the Monolith, tap it, key, blue mana here. Yeah, I think the play is Vampiric for Grim Monolith. Oh, I can go one more if I have to. Are you Grim Monolith? You're not Grim Monolith. Draw Grim Monolith. Oh, he's the second annul. Wow. That's going to just beat me. Yep. I can't get Delusions of Mediocrity down now. Crazy. Second annul beats me for sure. Oh, well. Tinker forces a game three. Alright, I said I wasn't going to sideboard until he proved he could beat me. Now I'm starting to wonder if I want these defense grids, because those annuls were super annoying. I mean, he has a bunch of mana to pay for stuff, though, right? Like, I often have enough. Wow, I mean, what would I take out? I think I'm on the play. Huh. I feel like making my deck reactive is awkward. Bringing a sideboard card against like three or four things. I'm not gonna do it. I'm just gonna play. Yes, I definitely want to play first. This draw looks pretty good. Right, it's Vampiric into turn two Show and Tell. So what? City of Traders will be my turn two land? So my turn one land is just Swamp? Sure. Yeah, this is a turn two bargain. Seems good. It's a turn two bargain that's not vulnerable to a null either, or a miscount. Yawgmoth's bargain goes on to the top. City of Traders. Mox Diamond. Is that Mox vulnerable to a null? He's threatened Dynamo. Now he's got miscalculation. But whatever. Six, seven, eight. probably worth getting it on tap step since none of these cards actually do anything. Yeah, I'm gonna get it on tap step. And a land drop. Yeah, what you got? 3, 4, Grand Dynamo, okay. Tap out for processor. Tangle wire is annoying. Huh. Yeah, that would be all my permanents. I guess I could intuition if I thought of it before I said okay. Oh yeah, I can still flip it. No. How does this work? I can play City of Traders for Scroll Rack. There's no reason not to. Finally a box diamond. So now I can get the monolith down. By playing Mox Diamond, tapping Mox for monolith. I'll have to have a key so that I can get a scroll rack activation in here. Close to being able to do awesome things. Seven rays, I could go. Oh, I could go Dark Ritual. Dark Ritual to get a scroll rack activation? Is that worth it? I don't even know. I think just Grim Monolith. It's not. And then say go again, get a land step, a tap step, and a land drop, and all that. I mean, he has to tap a couple things. It sure feels like a game I'm supposed to win. I've drawn a bunch of extra cards. I have a bunch of powerful things in my hand. I mean, Delusions lets me draw 10 more cards. I just have to play Delusions next turn. These turnabouts, I mean, they're definitely turning a profit, significant mana profit. Show and tell to save a mana on Delusions if I really want to. My only real question is whether I'm intuitioning for anything. Kept the dynamos but tapped his islands. Interesting. So I do not have to worry about this Cavalier at all. That's good. Process. Two floating so he can sack Crystal Vein and make a guy. Is he going to pay 10 life again? 7? Probably 10. Pays 8. Alright. If I say go, I die to be 8-8. But meanwhile, I only have to blaze for 12. Now, I have to worry about this Tangle Wire. Alright, Tangle Wire is going to tap 3 things. don't think it does me any good to tap them preemptively to float mana for intuition. Mostly, I just need to make sure I can show it tell. I mean, delusions. Right, he's totally tapped out. So, if I tap... what? Mox, Swamp, City? It's funny that the City Traders is one of the things to tap. I think it might be. I could have the Scroll Rack, but I kind of like having the ability to activate Scroll Rack in a pinch. So if I tap Mox, Swamp, City, I can then Monolith, Key, Mox, Mox, Turnabout myself, Delusions, draw a bunch more stuff, Turnabout myself. Yeah, I can only really afford to tap one Mox because I want the Turnabouts. All right, let's do it that way. So, three colorless. Six colorless. I guess I'm about to delusion that he's tapped out. I can draw these last three cards, can't I? That's not very exciting. Blue, blue. Talk about myself to untap all my artifacts. You gotta be kidding. It's my upkeep? Seriously? It's my upkeep. So stupid. Guess I'll use that mana in the Scroll Rack. Vampiric Tutor to reshuffle. I get Intuition to reshuffle. Vampiric Tutor seems better after I have Delusions. Did not realize I was still in my upkeep. But whatever. Should be fine. Some new cards. Squandered a couple colorless mana. It's not gonna matter. Luckily, Mana Burn's no longer a thing, right? Here we go. Blue. Three colorless. Delusions. Game 10. Now. I can Dark Ritual. I can go through the combo just to show it. Attack the Grim Monolith. Spending black mana. Lots of mana. Turn about myself. I'm tapping all of my artifacts. So here's three. That's 10. A Crystal Vein, just for fun. What's he at? 12? Vampiric Tutor for the Blaze. Dogmoth Bargain to draw a Blaze. Red to get it started. Crystal Vein for two more mana. So that's 8, 10, 11, 12. Blaze you for all of it. And there you see the Fools V Bargain combo in all of its glory. Nice. Good game, sir.
Oh, it's over? Good. All right. I was talking to the chat room, like,
I had nothing else to do at that point, right? Like, you win or you don't. All right, good games.
I wasn't particularly close. I actually even lost try. I was, like, in my upkeep and didn't even notice because I was responding to Tanglewire. Then I went to play Delusions, and it's like, you can't play. Why can't I play Delusions? Oh, because it's my stupid upkeep. I don't need those colorless mana anyway. We'll just go to my main phase. No problem.
Sure.
I think Ogmoth's world left over at the end. The second game was the super interesting one. I actually think I may have conceded prematurely in the second game because I could have, like, mocked Dark Ritual, activate Scroll Rack, and, like, cross my fingers. But Two Annuls was basically...
Two Annuls was useful. Like, I set myself up. Getting out the Phyrexian Dreadnought was just, you know, for funsies at the end. But I set it up with Two Annuls. Like, let's see what happens.
Makes sense.
And then I had to decide what I was going to hit. Like, I'm like, do I wait for Delusions? Do I... And I'm like, no, I just have to stop your mana. Like, if I stop your mana, I think you just run out of steam.
Yeah, and I didn't draw Grim Monolith, so I actually Vampiric for the second Grim Monolith, thinking I'll be fine. But the second Annul felt pretty backbreaking at that point.
Gotcha. Yeah, like, if I waited and did it on Delusions, like, maybe that works, but maybe you just get turnabouts and don't need it.
Right, exactly.
So, like, I was racking my brain for that. I'm like, you know, I'm just going to hit your fast mana, your big mana items. And luckily you threw two of them at me. I'm like, okay, I know to stop that. Yeah.
Alright. Sounds like did the stream freeze? It sounds like the stream may have froze briefly. So the end of the game was fairly anticlimactic. I mean, my bargain draws were great. I was able to play Delusions to draw extra cards, but I didn't even need them because I already had the two turnabouts. It's just turnabout, untap my artifacts, make a bunch more mana, turnabout, untap my artifacts, and then Delusions gave me the life I needed to Vampiric Tutor for the Blaze, and then Blaze. I mean, I Blazed it for 12. I could have Blazed it for, like, 30 or 40 at that point. Oh, by the way, I had a Yawgmoth's Will for still had all these. And, yeah, bargain. You got the one game with the two Annuls, but I got the other two, and bargain goes to the semis.